स्टूडेंट्स, आई राजेश्वरी शिरकनहल्ली वेलकम यू ऑल इन नागेश करसगी ऑर्किड स्कूल चैनल। स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर डिस्कसिंग चैप्टर नंबर 11, दैट इज वर्क एंड एनर्जी। आफ्टर कंप्लीशन ऑफ आवर डिस्कशन अबाउट वर्क, वी आर नाउ डिस्कसिंग अबाउट एनर्जी। इन द लास्ट सेशन वी हैव डिस्कस्ड दैट एनर्जी इज नथिंग बट द कैपेसिटी टू डू वर्क। सो फॉर डूइंग एनी वर्क एनर्जी इज required. We have also discussed about the law of conservation of energy, means energy can neither be created nor be destroyed. Only one form of energy can be converted to other form, and the total energy remains constant. So, as one form of energy can be converted into another form, means energy is available in different forms. We have discussed about different forms of energy. It is available as chemical energy, heat energy, solar energy, then nuclear energy, tidal energy, geothermal energy, mechanical energy, and so on. So, in this chapter, we are going to study only about mechanical energy. Mechanical energy is of two types. They are kinetic energy and potential energy. So, we started with our first mechanical energy, that is kinetic energy. So, what is kinetic energy? It is the energy possessed by the objects on account of their motion. Means all the moving objects have kinetic energy in them. We have derived the expression for kinetic energy. We have got the formula, that is Ek. Ek stand for energy kinetic, means kinetic energy is equal to half mv square, in which m stand for mass of the object and v stand for final velocity of the object. So, after arriving at the final expression, that is Ek is equal to half mv square, we will see some numericals, some solved examples based on that. So, the first numerical, first solved example is example 11.3. So, see what is given in the question and what you are supposed to find out. An object of mass 15 kg is moving with a uniform velocity of 4 meter second raised to minus 1. So, what are the given things? Mass is given 15 kg. See, you have to use the same formula. In this, substitute the value of m as 15 kg, and uniform velocity is given, that is 4 meter per second or ms raised to minus 1. What you have to find out? Kinetic energy possessed by the object. You have to find out the kinetic energy possessed by the object. So, let us find out. What is the formula? Ek is equal to half mv square. So, solution. Mass of the object m is equal to 15 kg. Velocity of the object v is equal to 4 ms raised to minus 1. So, you have to remember that the masses should be in the kilogram, velocities should be in meter per second. If they are in different units, you need to convert them in the kg and meter per second respectively. But here already the correct units are given. So, as it is, we can use these values. So, we have to find out Ek, that is kinetic energy. What is the formula? Ek is equal to 1 upon 2 m into v square. Just substitute all the values. 1 upon 2 into m is 15 kg into v square. V square means v into v. V value is 4. So, 4 meter per second into 4 meter per second. Here you can do the cancellation. 2 1s are 2 and 2 2s are 4. So, this 2 into 15 is 30. 30 into 4 is 120. So, the kinetic energy of the object is 120 joule. I hope you have understood this numerical, as it is very easy. Now, let us move to the next numerical, that is next solved example 11.4. What is the work to be done to increase the velocity of a car from 30 km per hour to 60 km per hour? If the mass of the car is 1500 kg. So, see here what are the given things. mass is given 1500 kg, it is in kg, so no need to do any conversion. And here velocity is increased from 30 to 60 km per hour. That means 30 km per hour is its initial velocity, that is the value of u, and 60 km per hour is its final velocity, that is the value of v. But as I have told that velocity must be in the unit meter per second, but here it is in kilometer per hour. So first we have to convert this into meter per second, and what you have to find out? Work done. So let us start. Solution: mass of the car, that is m, is equal to 1500 kg. As it is, we are going to use this value. Initial velocity of the car is u. As you know that initial velocity is denoted by the symbol u and final velocity is denoted by the symbol v. So initial velocity is u and it is 30 km per hour, but we require the unit meter per second. So we have to do the conversion. 30 into 1000 meter. You know that 1000 meter makes 1 kilometer. So when you are converting bigger to smaller unit, you need to multiply. So 30 multiplied by 1000 meter. Hours you have to convert into seconds. When you convert hours into minutes, you have to multiply by 60, and minutes to second multiply by 60. So you have to divide this by 60 into 60 because hours is in the denominator. 60 into 60, or you can directly write 3600, because you know that 1 hour means 3600 seconds. So here you can do the cancellation. This 0 and this 0 cancel. 3 ones are, 3 twos are. Then 2 into 500 is equal to 1000. That means you get 500 divided by 60. If you 0 0 cancel, means 50 upon 6, you can do the cancellation very easily. The value is 8.33 meter per second. So this is the initial velocity, means this is the value of u, 8.33 meter per second. Similarly, final velocity of the car is calculated. V value is given 60 km per hour. Same way you have to do the conversion. 60 into 1000 upon 60 into 60. So 60 from numerator and from denominator gets cancelled. You will get 1000 upon 60. 0 0 cancel, means you will get 100 upon 6. 100 upon 6 means it is 16.67 meter per second. Students, do the calculation, you will get the answer. V value is 16.67. Now we have u value 8.33 meter per second and v value 16.67 meter per second. Therefore, the initial kinetic energy of the car. So here you can use two formulae. Either you can find out the kinetic energy, which is initial kinetic energy, by taking the value of u, and you can find the final kinetic energy by taking the value of v. Otherwise, directly you can use Ek is equal to half m in bracket v square minus u square. Anyways, let us see. So this is Ek, I stand for initial kinetic energy, is equal to half m u square. Here you are not supposed to write v square, you have to write u square, because we are finding the initial kinetic energy. So substitute the values. Half into m value is 1500 into u square, that is the square of 8.33, which we obtained here in this calculation. So after doing this, you will get the value 52041.68 joule. Okay, means 52041.68 joule. That is the initial kinetic energy. Similarly, we have to find out the final kinetic energy of the car, that is EKF. F stand for final kinetic energy. Same formula, but here instead of u, you have to use v, means you have to use the formula EKF is equal to half mv square. Half into m is 1500 kg, into v value we have calculated by conversion, we got 16.67. square of this So by doing this multiplication, cancellation, everything, you will get the value 208416.68 joule. But for finding the work done, we need change in the kinetic energy. Change in the kinetic energy means final kinetic energy minus initial kinetic energy. So the final kinetic energy, this value minus initial kinetic energy is this value. You have to just carry out the subtraction, you will get the work done is equal to 156375 joules, means it is 156375 joule is the work done in this case. Okay students, after solving the numericals, let us see the second type of mechanical energy, that is potential energy. So we have discussed about kinetic energy, that it is the energy possessed by the object on account of its motion. We have derived the expression, that is Ek is equal to half mv square. We have seen the solid examples. You are going to practice the examples given in the exercise also. Now let us move to the next type of energy, that is potential energy. To understand about potential energy, there is an activity given, activity 11.8. In this, you have to take a rubber band. You know that rubber band is elastic. Hold it at one end and pull from the other. What happens when you pull the rubber band? The band stretches. Stretches means its shape changes, isn't it? Release the band at one of the ends. What happens? The band will tend to regain its original length. Obviously, the band had acquired energy in its stretched position. So when we release the one end of the stretched rubber band, it tries to regain its original length. For doing so, it requires some energy. That means it has some energy. It has got acquired some energy, and this energy is obtained in the stretched position. That means in this particular position, there is some energy stored. So how did it acquire energy when stretched? See, when we stretch the rubber band, means we do some work on that, and that work gets stored in the form of potential energy in the stretched rubber band. I know definitely you will try this activity at home. Now, next activity, more to understand about this potential energy. Activity 11.9. In this, you have to take a slinky, which is shown here. You know, slinky means it has many turns. Ask a friend to hold one of its ends. You hold the other end and move away from your friend. And now you release the slinky. So you can use a slinky. It is somewhat like a spring in the ballpoint pen. You tell your friend or any family member to hold one end of this slinky, and you hold the other end of the slinky and go away from your friend or family member. Then release the slinky. What happens when you release the slinky? What happened? How did the slinky acquire energy when stretched? So same way, when you stretch the slinky, go away from the other person, the energy stored in this slinky, and when you release it, it acquires its original position. Would the slinky acquire energy when it is compressed? Yes. So when we stretch or compress, we do some kind of work on the slinky, and energy gets stored in the slinky in both the forms. Next activity is activity 11.10. Take a toy car, wind its using its key. Okay, so you have to use a toy car which works on the key, not on the battery. So use a toy car, wind it using its key, place the car on the ground. What happens? It starts moving, isn't it? From where did it acquire energy? It gets energy for moving. That energy is stored in the toy car because of winding its key. Does the energy acquired depends on the number of windings? Yes. If you wind the key for less number of times, then it moves to a less distance. If you wind the key for more turns, then the car moves to a longer distance. So you can test that by winding the different numbers, less windings and more windings, and you can measure how much distance it covers after leaving it, after placing it on the floor. Now the next activity, that is activity 11.11, is lift an object through a certain height. The object can now do work. It begins to fall when released. So when you release any object which is lifted to a certain height, starts falling down. It does some work. This implies that it has acquired some energy. If raised to a greater height, it can do more work and hence possesses more energy. Okay, so to what height you raise the object, depending on that, it do different amounts of work. If you raise to a less height, it does less work while moving downward, and if you raise to a more height, then it does more work. From where did it get the energy? It get the energy because it gets stored when we raise that object to a certain height. So let us see, we will discuss more about this. In the above situations, the energy stored due to the work done on the object, stretching the rubber band or winding the toy car or using the slinky and stretching it or compressing it and then taking the object to a certain height, in all these situations we have done some work on these objects. The energy transferred to an object is stored as potential energy if it is not used to cause a change in the velocity or speed of the object. So when we do such type of work on these objects, this work gets transferred in the energy, and that energy is called as potential energy, which remains in these objects. You transfer energy when you stretch a rubber band. The energy transferred to the band is its potential energy. So while stretching the rubber band, we do some work on this rubber band, and the energy is transferred to that rubber band in the stretched position as potential energy. You do work while winding the key of a toy car. Similarly, when we wind the key of a toy car, we do some work on the toy car, and the energy transferred to the spring inside is stored as potential energy. The potential energy possessed by the object is the energy present in it by virtue of its position or configuration. So what is potential energy? It is the energy possessed by the objects which is present in the object by virtue of its position or configuration. We have discussed about kinetic energy, that is the energy possessed by the object on account of its motion. And here potential energy means the energy possessed by the object on account of its position or configuration. Now let us move to the next activity, activity 11.12. In this you have to take a bamboo stick and make a bow as shown here in the figure. So in this activity you require a bamboo stick and you have to make a bow which is shown here. Place an arrow made of light stick on it with one end supported by the stretched string. Okay, so this is a arrow which is made up of light stick and one end is supported by the stretched string. Now stretch the string and release the arrow. So when we stretch this string, arrow is released, isn't it? Notice the arrow flying off the bow. So what happens? The arrow fly off from the bow and go and fall somewhere, hit somewhere. Notice the change in the shape of the bow. The potential energy stored in the bow due to the change of shape is thus used in the form of kinetic energy in throwing off the arrow. So when we release that arrow, what happens? Why the arrow is thrown off? Because it gets energy in the form of kinetic energy and it utilizes that energy from the stretched bow. The bow changes its shape and thus it changes, it gives that potential energy to the arrow, means the energy gets transferred and arrow get the energy and it goes and throws off. Means here conversion of potential energy to kinetic energy takes place in this case. Now the next concept is potential energy of an object at a height. An object increases its energy when raised through a height, isn't it? When we raise the object at particular height, the energy in that object gets increased. This is because work is done on it against gravity while it is being raised. So you know that gravity is always acting in the downward direction, but when we raise any object, then we do the work on that object which is against gravity. The energy present in such an object is the gravitational potential energy. So this potential energy which is stored in the object, which is in the opposite of gravitational force, that is called as gravitational potential energy. The gravitational potential energy of an object at a point above the ground is defined as the work done in raising it from the ground to that point against gravity. So, what is the definition of gravitational potential energy? It is the energy of an object at a height above the ground, okay, and it is defined as the work done in raising it from the ground to that point where that object is placed, to that point against gravity. It is easy to arrive at an expression for the gravitational potential energy of an object at a height. Now look at the figure. Consider an object of mass m. Okay, so here an object is shown. Consider its mass is m. Let it be raised to a height h. So this is the new position of the object, that is the raised position of the object, and suppose this height is equal to h from the ground. A force is required to do this. So for raising the object at this particular height h, we require a force. The minimum force required to raise the object is equal to the weight of the object mg. So F is equal to mg, force is equal to weight, because weight is also a kind of force, and the formula for weight is mg, mass into gravitational force, acceleration due to gravity. The object gains energy equal to work done on it. Let the work done on the object against gravity be W. So work is done for raising this object, and this work is done against gravity because we are raising it in the upward direction. So work done W is equal to force into displacement. We have seen in the beginning of the chapter that W is equal to Fs. F is force and S is displacement. Now here force is equal to weight, that is mg, and displacement is nothing but that height, that is h. So we get mg into h, that is mgh, means work done is equal to mgh. Since work done on the object is equal to mgh, an energy equal to mgh units is gained by the object. So this energy is potential energy. So potential energy of the object Ep. We have seen that kinetic energy is expressed Ek, K for kinetic, and here it is expressed as Ep, P for potential. So Ep is equal to mgh, that is the formula for potential energy. Kinetic energy we have seen, Ek is equal to half mv square, and for potential energy Ep is equal to mgh. Now more to know, the potential energy of an object at a height depends on the ground level or the zero level you choose. Okay, so what is the ground level or any level in between, you can consider it as a zero level. From there, at what height the object is placed or raised, depending on that the potential energy depends on of the object. An object in a given position can have a certain potential energy with respect to one level and a different value of potential energy with respect to another level. So what ground level or zero level you choose, depending on that the potential energy changes of the object raised to a particular height. It is useful to note that the work done by the gravity depends on the difference in vertical heights of the initial and final positions of the object and not on the path along which the object is moved. So, work is done on the object to raise the object at a particular height, and in this case the initial and the final position of the objects are only considered, the vertical height in between them. It doesn't depend on what path you have taken to move the object, to raise the object. Now, here the following figure, that is figure 11.8, shows a case where a block is raised from A to B by taking two different paths. Let the height AB is equal to H. So, look at this, both the figures. This is the initial position of the object A, which are at the same level, and the final position of the object is B, which are again at the same level. So, what is done here? The object is raised straight in the vertically upward direction. So, this is the first path, and consider this height in between A and B is H. In second case, again the height between A and B is same, because B is at the same level, A is also at the same level of this. So, this is also H, but here the object is not moved straight, it is just taken some different turns, first to the right side, then in the upward direction, then left side, and finally at the same final position. So, in both the situations the work done is same. So, the work done in both the situations is equal to mgh. It doesn't depend on what path you have chosen, it depends only on the initial and the final position of the objects. The initial position and the final position both are same in these both the situations. So, same work is done, that is equal to mgh. Now, let us see one solid example of this. Example 11.5. Students, you need to solve all these examples in your notebook. Here you have to find the energy possessed by an object of mass 10 kg. So, here the value of m, that is mass, is given 10 kg. So, again remember the mass should be in kilogram. If it is given in kilogram, you can use this value as it is. If it is not in kilogram, you have to convert into kilogram. So, when it is at a height of 6 meter. So, here the h value is given 6 meter, again the height, length, distance, displacement, all this should be in meter. If they are in centimeter, kilometer, something, again you have to convert them into meter. So, the height is 6 meter above the ground. Given g value is given, that is 9.8 meter per second square. So, let us see how to solve. Mass of the object is 10 kg given. Displacement, that is height h, is equal to 6 meter, acceleration due to gravity g is equal to 9.8 meter per second square. Okay, all the three values are given. Just now we have got the equation, that is the formula for finding the potential energy, that is Ep, potential energy, is equal to mgh. Just substitute all the three values, m is 10, g is 9.8, h is 6. Just multiply, 10 into 9.8 is 98, 98 into 6 is 588 joule. So, the potential energy is 588 joules. So, students, today we have discussed about kinetic energy and potential energy. In the last session, we derived the expression for kinetic energy. We got kinetic energy is equal to half mv square. Today, we have discussed the solved numericals, solved examples of that. Then we started with another type of energy, that is potential energy. We derived at its expression Ep is equal to mgh, and we have seen the solved example. So, go through these concepts, mark important points and prepare your questions, different type of MCQs from this. So, today we will stop here. Thank you.